I'm gonna start off with all that evil. All that evil is there for is to push humans to the next level. Because if there was no bad, then how would you ever be able to have good? It'd just be a total blank space. So you need that bad, but also you need to choose a side and be conscious that that bad's there. Because if you're not, you can become part of the force that actually brings you humanity not down, but you sort of bring yourself down. You become part of the negative instead of part of the positive. So, for anybody who's like in fear of anything really, all you have to do is just never give up. Just have that attitude and don't, you know, say you crash your car and you know you walk out and you're like, well, I don't care, I'm never going to give in, and someone's in your face like, what's up with you, why are you not annoyed, whatever, just be like, so what, do what I want and have that strength of, you know, no matter what anybody says to you, you're doing what you want to do. And you might get something wrong where you think, oh my God, I can't believe I got that wrong. But don't let that thought enter your mind. Just be like, oh yeah, I got it wrong. Pew! See you later. And just move on. Reborn back into the moment. But if you start dwelling in the past, if you dig up the past, then all you get is dirt. That's what some people say. It's alright to dwell in the past on things you want to dwell on, but the things you don't want to dwell on, just see you later. So I'm just gonna talk a little bit about my workout and my favourite workout. My favourite workout is my shoulder workout, because you see your shoulder is, it's a ball and socket, so it can move all the way around and it can move all the way around that way. No other joints can do that. Your neck can only go side to side, forward and back. You can sort of go around, but not as much as your shoulder. It's a lot more restricted. So, because your shoulders are that, they have that much movability in them, that a lot of stress gets stored in your back, and I can literally see it in some people sometimes. You know, they don't even have to tell me they've got a stiff back, and it goes all the way up to the neck as well, because you know your shoulders are near your neck, so you can see this, you know, that's where the stress is stored. That's why when you're getting a massage, where they go straight away, they go near your back and near your neck, and they rub you the back of your shoulders. So that's why I do it, because it gets rid of stress. And it also does your chest. When you're doing your, you know, inclined chest, inclined shoulders, you're also getting a bit of your chest. When I'm doing my shoulders, I also do 45-minute shoulders. I only do like one workout a week. Do 45 minutes primary shoulders, but then I do a little bit of back, quite heavy, because you're gonna get a bit of your shoulders in there. Literally every single bit of my shoulders, I do. And then I do biceps, because even though you don't think you're doing your shoulders, for one, you don't do your biceps when you're doing your shoulders, so you need to do your biceps. But it also, your shoulders are also connected to your biceps. So when you think, I'm not doing my shoulders here, your shoulders are actually stabilizing your arms for your arms to be able to lift you the weight. So, I've got explain reality. If a group of Muslims in general talk English different, they have different accents, and you say that they have different accents, that's not racism. Why is that not racism? So most people out there, they'll be thinking that is racism. But why is it not racism? Because it's true. Something's true. If something is a stereotype, it is a stereotype. So don't let them. Because if they can get you to say black is white, then they can get you to accept anything. If they can get you to constantly thinking, I don't know whether it's racist or not, like, it can get so bad as if to say, like I just said, then they can get you to accept black is white. Just saying them words, some people now think that they just don't say them words. Even though they're white, they will, they'll just stay like people. They just, as soon as you start talking about politics, they just that's it. They just shut up straight away. Soon as you start talking about racism and stuff like that, they don't want to talk about it because they've been brainwashed. So how do I know the plan to enslave humanity is true? Because I know we have the technology currently, never mind the shallow stuff to build up Africa now. It's like, I think they say, like, with solar panels, if we just cover like the state of Texas in solar panels, it would power the world. And solar panels is like 1970s technology, probably discovered in the 60s. Probably like started getting developed in the 50s, rolled out to the public in the 70s. So imagine what they've got now. We're in nearly in 2020. So. And you've got to, take into account that it's exponential. Technology's exponential. Everything, healthcare, all gets better and better. But the problem is they've decided that the world is overpopulated, and we're a disease, and only them can fly around on the private jets, only them can fly around in helicopters, when in actual fact we should all have a helicopter by now. That's the next step. The next step from cars is helicopters. After that it's planes. After planes it's jets. They've all got the jets already. We're in cars, some of us on buses, and we say, oh yeah, Leonardo DiCaprio, yeah, he's got a right to fly around on jets, talking about climate change when he's got the biggest carbon footprint in the world. What an absolute scumbag. So what does suggestible mean? Suggestible means, these are the terms we need to start getting familiar with if you want to have any chance of bringing this thing down. We need to stop thinking about Arsenal as a football club. We need to start thinking about Arsenal as like an actual Arsenal. What the proper dictionary, a gun Arsenal. We need to just get involved in this stuff. And if you don't like it, then fair enough. If you like listening to, you know, fucking Stormzy and all that shit, then you go and listen to Stormzy. But I'm telling you now, listening to Stormzy ain't gonna make you happy. There's gonna come a point in your life where you're 35 years old and you're still listening to Stormzy when he's 50, and it's just gonna drop into your head, and you're gonna think, fucking hell, this guy's just fucking having me over here, just taking my money, telling me what's cool. You define what's cool, not him. You have your own ideology. Don't live his. Let him live his. If he wants to do that, let him do it. But don't be obsessed with it. So, let's say you're somebody who pours concrete for a living and digs up roads and digs holes. If you have your own ideology, your own idea of freedom, then you are a lot more important to this world and more valuable than somebody like David Beckham, Michael Jordan. You're not much above them, but you're still above them because you've gone to that next level. They're above you if they're in this game of freedom, because they have more money, they have more resources. But if they're just flying around the planet, traveling the world, fucking playing football with, you know, a load of kids to get the for a PR stunt or basketball or whatever, they're not really contributing to anything. Been a bit of. So how do you get energy? What gives you energy? Well, food gives you energy, doesn't it? I'm not saying do this too much. If you want more energy, then what you need to do is have more fluids and have more food. Don't have things like too much coffee or too much tea, too much McDonald's, but the other things like water and pasta, have plenty. And sometimes you're not going to feel like eating, or you're not going to feel like drinking. Just get it down, you know, not too much, but just think, right, well, I've not had a glass of water or a pint of water or a pint of milk for about an hour and a half now. Just get it down, you know, watch how much more energy you get and how more focused you are. So I think in school we should be taught about these things. We shouldn't be, you know, before we know it, looking at sums and punctuation and all this stuff. Before we've even touched on nutrition, the first thing we should be taught, or the thing we should be taught when our brains are at the most suggestible, as that word, is, suggestible is probably not the right word, because, you know, there's manipulating connotations. Who cares about connotations anyway? I'm using it in a different context, so fuck connotations for this sentence. Yeah, we should be talking about nutrition, you know, from say 1 till, well, not 1, let them play or whatever, you know. I've not done the studies, but they've all done them, they will have done them behind the scenes, you know, when we should be playing with, you know, toys, and then when we should be being taught about nutrition, whatever, 1 to 5, play with, you know, our friends or whatever, our brothers and sisters, 5 to 10, you know, it needs to be, just every single day needs to be taught about nutrition, water, calories, how, you know, this stuff gets you, the water and the pasta gets your brainwaves going, how it makes your body work better, how it helps you with anxiety, how it helps you socially, how it helps you to make relationships, how it helps you to relax, how it helps you to sleep. Just 5 to 10, you know, that's just my guess. It should, might be more. I definitely don't think it should be less. No maths, no English, 5 to 10, just nutrition. At least 5 years. And you ought to see, like, I think humanity is amazing now. You do that, we will be unbelievable. So I've got more here. I'm probably gonna do a bit more later. Just gonna end this video here. Got a few videos to upload and name, and I'll do a few other things, so I'll upload a few more later.